Our workshop is about building community capacity around veterans. And this last session is about thriving veteran-friendly communities. And we're going to be talking about pathways and resources. So the session overview, we are going to be reviewing the homework from session two. Hopefully you had a chance to view that short video on bridge building, the bridge building activity. We're going to be discussing bridge building partners and pathways, and then we're going to head into a resource overview. So our learning objectives for today, we are hoping that you all will get a start on, at least envisioning desired conditions for your communities and organizations, assess current conditions, and identify action steps needed to get you where you want to go. And also to gain awareness of programs and organizations and resources available to veterans at all sorts of levels, national, state, and local. And Crystal, I will turn it over to you to get us started.
Thanks, everyone. As Bridget mentioned, we hope you had an opportunity to watch the short bridge building video. And we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about building a bridge. And so when you're thinking about bridge building, think of it in the framework of, as community planning, that it's like community planning. You want to have some agreement on where you're headed, right? So you need to know where you're going, where you want to go, and have some agreement there. It helps you look at both ends of the process and where both ends will be. And then it starts with the end. So where do you want to go? What's the vision? What's the aspiration? So you start there, and if you saw the video, that's your wow. And then it backs up to say, okay, so that's where we want to go. That's our aspiration, our goal, our vision for our community or our group or our project. Let's get back to what's the situation now. So where are we? And then you work in the middle. So how do we cross the bridge to get from where we are now to get to our wow, our aspiration, our goal, our vision? So when you think of the wow, right, that's the end, that's the other side. What does that look like? What can you imagine? So you would think if, you maybe pose a question like this. If we were successful in pursuing this goal, what would success look like? So imagine your wow. So thinking about what your project, your goals, your efforts might be. What might the wow be? It may be something around veteran entrepreneurship. It may be something around housing. It may be something around workforce opportunities with veterans, but thinking about your wow. So the way we're gonna talk about the bridge building activity is we're gonna, on each of the sections, we're gonna spend a little bit of time, quietly thinking, jotting down some thoughts. We're going to ask you to post your thoughts in the chat, and we're going to share out some of the thoughts that are shared so we can spend some time learning from one another. So this may be hard for some of us who think out loud, but just, that's fine. Keep your mute button on. Think out loud if you need to. But we're going to take a quiet 30 seconds and jot down or think about our wow. And then when you're ready, you can start posting that in the chat box. So I am going to start my timer so that we are on time. All right. And so thinking about what your wow, if we were successful in pursuing this goal, what would success look like? All right. Quiet meeting now. All right. So if you could start typing some of your thoughts in the chat box, and we'll ask some of you, as we are looking in the chat, we may ask some of you to share that out loud if you're comfortable. What is your wow? I know you have goals and things that you want to see happen. So what are they? What do you want to see happen?
So I think what I learned even after the last few conversations we've had, the goal for me, looking at like the seven capitals and what we're missing in our community, it's really just the culture surrounding the veterans. We don't really do a lot of events. We don't really give a lot of resources out to our veterans like we probably should, even just to help identify them, which would help me and other nonprofits here in our area. So my goal is basically to increase the veteran culture in my area by providing more veteran-friendly or veteran-specific events.
Ellen is talking about strong connections. Are you able to unmute Ellen and share?
So yeah, just because I'm a graduate student, so we're going to do some research stuff. So I think really the goal is to build those networks and connections so that we have the resources both from a population of participants for research, but also just the community support for this type of programming and research.
Thank you. There's a lot of folks on and a lot of things happening in New Jersey, so it seems like that will be a great project to make those connections. And Ray is sharing about in the past 15 years, Iowa has only reduced the rate of children living in poverty. Oh, wow. Ray, do you want to unmute and share a little bit more?
Sure. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Sounds okay. I'll just say that we served our country. Now we want to serve our communities. In Iowa, 90% of our food dollar goes out of state. Iowa has 120,000 paired watershed sites. And we bought one, and now we capture the surface runoff, and we intercept farm tile, and we're using that water for food production. So we have no cost of operation, no risk to starting a business, and we're doing high-value food crops. The Army Corps of Engineers designed the Rebuild Iowa project after the flood of 93, and they did it for the entire drainage to the Mississippi River and the Gulf. And all those plans got broke up and buried in the archives. So we're doing school projects, STEM project students, and they went and dug it all back out. And 2 months ago, I got put on Department of Land Stewardship's website. But now we suit to file a FOIA because all those 120,000 sites are mapped. We want to buy those. It's runoff, it's marginal ground. We want to buy them. And for beginning farmers, these small pieces of ground, 5 acres, 10 acres, yet those maps are still locked up in the DNR's office. We want to access those maps so we can buy those sites. And my site's in town. So I do the stuff at the school. We've got the Governor's Award for Best STEM, K-12 for Ankeny School District. And so all my customers come from school. I can't even feed them all. We need about 6-7 more sites around here just to feed that one population. So I got an email 2 weeks ago from Iowa State Extension, and they're doing STEM projects for STEM externs under the Governor's Program. They brought some science teachers here. And now I got an email from a lady that's hired by Isaac Walton League of America, and they're gonna teach water quality and soil erosion to Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts for merit badges. And they can be a local resource for water quality, environmental issues, and relating back to our food insecurity. And they're coming, bringing their STEM externs next week. It's funded by that conservation group. So we'd like to have, you know, in small town Iowa, They're closing these businesses and venues, but they're still VFW and Legion. And now they're hosting weddings there. That could be our anchor group to take these STEM projects across the state and include the Scouts and FFA and that type of thing.
Yeah, thanks, Ray. And I see you bottom lined it as your wow, access to land.
Yeah. Right.
Thanks so much, Ray, for sharing that. Kayla, I see Kayla noted end goal to increase the number of local veterans involved in the ag community in your county and create a community in which veterans can learn from veterans in a mentoring relationship. Thanks, Kayla, for sharing that as well. So that's, you know, we have our end goals, our vision. You have to know where you're going or where you want to go, right, so that you can get there. But then we have to take a step back and say, that's where we want to go. So let's go back to the start of the bridge and say, what's the situation now? What's the current reality? What is it going to take you know, what do we have in place now that we've got to change or build upon or expand or remove in order to get there? What's the current reality? What's the now? So we're going to do the same thing and take a 30-second time to think about, you know, what that is, and we'll post some of those in the chat as well. So 30-second quiet meeting starting now. All right. So if you'll share some of those thoughts in the chat box. What's the situation now? Ray shared some of his situation now already, but what are some others? What's your now situation? Ms. Ellen, current reality, diverse and unconnected population of veterans and stakeholders in New Jersey. You might share local veteran events focusing only on Veterans Day. Focus should be year round. That's great. Kayla, are you able to unmute and share out?
So I'm recently been included in a statewide group through WSU Extension in Washington that is going to be providing our Cultivating Success 12-week workshops. And the target audience is our veteran community. This group has been around for forever, and I was pulled onto the group less than a month ago. And so you can't target people if you don't know who they are. And target is probably the wrong word, but I'm going to go with it because it's an early morning for me. So I know the value of building relationships, and I can't do that from sitting on my own couch at home. And I can't, like I said before, I can't wait till I can actually get out to meet the people, my local people. It's just not a group that I've reached out to yet, and that will need to be fixed here pretty soon.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for sharing that. And I see Nick posted, rural area veterans are dispersed and services are centralized. Yeah. So there's the where we want to go, and then there's the present reality. So how do you get from your now to your wow? What are the actions that you can take to bridge that gap, to get you from the present reality to your goal, to the aspiration? So we'll do one more opportunity to just quietly think and share out what are some of the actions, what are some of the planned actions or actions in place now to move you from the current reality to your aspirations. And now once again, set my 30-second timer. All right, so if you can post in the chat some of the actions that you plan to take, hope to take, or are taking to bridge the gap between your current reality and where you want to go. Somebody could share join veteran-friendly community organizations as an action item. Another, applying for grants specifically for veterans events. Right? Networking, being more community involved through the current position. Rally the troops, I love that it's all caps. Rally the troops and bring awareness to the needs of veterans. Those are each some specific action items. And Ellen sharing networking, generate excitement and buy-in, spread the word. Yes, networking, because networking comes up a lot. Networking, meeting people. Sure. To that point, you know, back in session one, we talked about the sea of goodwill and that there's a lot out there, but without making the connection, sometimes they disjoint it and people don't know what other groups are doing or what resources are available. So that networking can be key across a lot of our work and projects. It's really good. So we're going to start to wind down this session, but this building a bridge activity really helps, you know, individuals and groups to think about, you know, what it is you want to do. So really gathering, if it's a group project, group effort, you know, gathering the team around what is the wow? What is our aspiration? What's our vision? What is it that we want to accomplish? And so you get that vision in mind and you start there so that you can see the ultimate end goal. Then you back up and you use data, you use tools, you know, like we used the community capitals framework and the seven capitals to frame out some of the reality. What are the assets? What are the resources that are in place? Who are the partners that we have or that we could reach out to or expand? What's the current? What do we have in place? We talked about data. So what's the data? What are the data telling us from our community? That's the now situation. Or we're, you know, we're quarantined. We can't travel and go out. Those are some of the now situations. And all of that really helps to funnel what is it that needs to happen? What's the how? What are those action items? And as you think about the action items, you may, you know, as you really start to comb through the action items and what needs to happen, you may have a really long list. So you might spend some time prioritizing what are the action items that might yield the best benefit, or what are the action items that should be done, you know, first. Some may take a little longer. So you may really start to dig a little deeper into those action items and even break those out a little further when you really start working through the process. So I hope that you find the tool useful. Gemma, I hope I'm saying your name right, Gemma. Correct me if I'm mispronouncing your name. Have information on a group of stakeholders in Jersey that are all about the veteran community and will share the contact information. We are looking forward to getting that information from you. That will be fantastic. Did I get it right, Gemma?
Yes.
Yes, all right. Great. Thank you so much, because the whole next section is on resource sharing, and that's what we want to hear. So you are spot on. So before we fully go to the next section, we want to wrap this up with an activity that's called Group Anthem. So we're going to do a Group Anthem activity. And what we're going to do is we're going to ask you to, those of you who are willing to unmute and share, we're going to unmute and share a very short response to one of these phrases. So you choose one of these phrases, and they come out of the Building a Bridge activity. I want, and then you fill in the blank. I have, and then you fill in the blank. And I will, and then you fill in the blank. So you choose one of those. Does that make sense, everybody? Thumbs up if you can wave. So, and we won't stop and go in between. If you're ready and willing to share, you unmute and share, and we'll have a couple people share out, you know, and you choose one. I want, I have, and or I will. That make sense?
Right. One thing I have done is when I do projects, I join other groups, organizations, I look at their mission statements and see if they're mission statement suits some of my outcome goals, and I do projects, and then if we get recognition, I wear their hat or their shirt, because that builds you a larger support group.
Yeah, good strategy, thanks. All right, so Group Anthem, I want, I have, or I will. Whoever's ready to start, you just unmute and get it started.
I will continue to learn and become culturally competent working with a veteran audience.
Anyone else willing to share what they will do, what they currently have, or what they want?
I currently have just good working relationships and people that will help me get to my goals.
I'll share mine. I will continue to listen and learn every day. As we know, there are so many resources, and on this session, so many talented people and passionate people, and you have a great bit to share. So we're gonna transition into a resource overview, and I'll share this time with Bridget, who's gonna lead that discussion with us. But we thank you, and we hope that you are willing to share what you know, and the resources that are available. So Bridget, I'm turning it over to you.
Thank you, Crystal. Thanks everyone for sharing. I know, you know, everyone has different comfort levels with all this, but it's just wonderful to hear from everyone and to hear where you're heading and how you think you might get there where you are now. So thank you. This is a resource overview section, and I want to just begin with sharing the caveat. All the resources I have to share in these slides currently are also available on the website as a Word document that you can download. So I am very happy to go through these resources and just kind of give a quick little overview of each one. However, as we've been working through this workshop and getting to know one another, you all have so many resources to share. And I was thinking that one thing that might be more beneficial is if you would all take a minute to think about two or three resources that you just really rely on, your go-to, what has really helped you in your work with veterans, and then share those in the chat. And my intention will be then to compile all the resources that have been shared from the very first session. And I will update that Word document on the website for everyone to download, and we'll also email it out to all of you. So if you want to take just a little minute here to type in the chat, and we want to capture them in the chat so that I can compile them later, type in the chat those resources that have been just really meaningful and really helpful to you. And then because it matters, you know, how and why they've been meaningful, if you would care to unmute and just talk about one or two resources that you want to say how you've used them, or how they've been so helpful, or why they've been so helpful, that would be great. And while you're thinking, I'll go ahead and share a resource and I guess shamelessly plug my own organization, which is the Military Families Learning Network. And just listening to folks talk this morning, and you know, networking is kind of emerging as such an important thing to be doing with all of this work. And it certainly has, it's presenting some challenges for all of us to do that kind of networking work when we're at home and unable to meet with people. And I would like to direct you to our Military Families Learning Network website. And Sarah Boffman, if you have a minute, Sarah Boffman works with me on this project. We have several free webinars on how to build networks, how to work out loud, so how to connect with others in doing the work that you're doing, make those connections even when you're stuck at home working on your computer. These are all free online sessions that you can view, and they're just really helpful, really wonderful to get you thinking about ways to build out your network, share the work that you're doing, make those contacts when you're working from home. So I see Gemma is sharing the New Jersey SOS stakeholders meetings for veteran with the contact information. Thank you so much, Gemma, for sharing that. So she's got a URL in there and also a name and email. So awesome. Sarah has the MFLN website in there, a blog post. I guess the resources are going to start flying in the chat. So rather than me trying to keep up with them, if anyone wants to unmute and just share what's been helpful for you and why, that would be awesome.
This is Ray. When we built this, our new house in Barnon on a new urban farm, I brought in Iowa State Extension, mm-hmm. and they designed the barn so we could provide hands-on training site so others could use the space for training. So we have indoor activities, indoor commercial cook center. We have outdoor activities from raised bed gardens of special needs to regular gardens to an outdoor cook center. So we have an attached greenhouse. It's got Wi-Fi inside, central air. So It's a multi-purpose, multi-use setting, and that's brought in a lot of the school kids. We provide, and a lot of the veterans teach programs and share their skills so they become resources mm-hmm. in the community. They become comfortable in speaking in front of a group. If you attend a program, if you're a veteran or a veteran's family, is free, but if you're a student and civilians, you pay to come to the programs. So it supplies us revenue. And so there's no cost for us to, you know, keep that going. It's, you know,
that's
becoming
great.
Fairly well known. So we have a working farm, the Watershed Negation Farm. We built that barn, and that's part of the Cherry Glen Learning Farm Center, and that's just like a separate entity, but we don't have any grants for it. It's just self-funding by being a resource.
What a great resource, great partnership that you've built, and it sounds like it's a win for everyone involved. So thanks for sharing that, Ray. I see that Gemma sharing the upcoming stakeholders meeting, which looks like it's tomorrow. So she's got a link in the chat here for anyone who's interested. It's a Zoom meeting. Thank you so much, Gemma, for sharing that. And Mike shared supportive services for veterans and families, his county veteran service officers, his regional manager and mentor. That's awesome. Thank you. Let me see what else I missed in here. Any other go-to resources that you all just have found super helpful? And you can keep thinking about them. I'll go ahead and start kind of working my way through some of the resources we have compiled for all of you. And again, these are on the slides, which you'll have access to, but also they are in a Word document that I will be adding some value to with all of the input from you all. So we'll start off with the Interagency Task Force on Agriculture and Rural Prosperity. This group has done some work and identified five key areas to support ag and rural prosperity and like e-connectivity, quality of life, supporting rural workforces, innovation, and economic development. So you can download a copy of that report at the link here on the screen, and that's also what's in your Word document. And it's relevant to working with veterans since they're, you know, pretty much an overrepresented in rural populations. And so part of rural workforce development is to connect these vets to underutilized training programs. And USDA offers a lot of home loans for buying and building and repairing homes, with many programs available for individuals, nonprofits, and lenders. So definitely check that link out as a resource for home loans. SNAP, you might all be familiar with, but that's the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program for families. So if you're working with individuals and families who need that sort of assistance, you can get some more information there. There are lots of farm service loans available, and many with special programs for beginning farmers and ranchers. There's also another workshop that this group is doing on specifically beginning farmers, rural farmers. Obviously, we're all beginning farmers and ranchers. So if you haven't seen that workshop, that's available as well. The VA is an obvious resource for sure, but I think it doesn't have to be or shouldn't necessarily be the go-to or the only resource. And as Bill has pointed out to me, you know, many well-meaning organizations will simply refer veterans to VA offices, but not all vets are registered with the VA. So that's a caveat. And the VA can also be really difficult to navigate, as many of you probably know. But the VA Community Veterans Engagement Board has state level offices that engage vets and service members and military families to work together and develop community goals and resolve any gaps in service at the local level. So this is a link to a searchable state level map to identify names and contact info of individuals who are working in your areas for the Community Veterans Engagement Board in each state. So definitely check that out. There is also a directory of veterans services organizations. This PDF, it's a 75-page PDF, just to warn you, but you can download it for a comprehensive list of those veterans service organizations. And the National Association of State Directors of Veteran Affairs is a state-level association of state directors of veteran affairs, and the website is also searchable by state at this link, so that's another good one to check out. I'm gonna get tongue-tied on all these acronyms. The National Association of Counties has veteran-specific issues at the county level, and these are all searchable on the website linked here. The National Association of County Veteran Service Officers is a congressionally recognized VSO that provides training, accreditation, and advocacy support to municipal, county, state, and tribal veterans advocates. So definitely check that out as well. Cooperative Extension, Ray has mentioned Cooperative Extension. So it's an excellent resource. I know, I think it was Kayla who's working with Cooperative Extension, a couple of folks. So excellent national resource operating in every county of every state and offers county level programming. So get in touch with your county extension agent, your county extension offices, and start networking there and finding out what's available. Thanks, Kayla. And Nick is asking to share a link to the slides. Rachel, I don't know what the plan is for sharing the slides, but if you wouldn't mind putting that in the chat. I don't know whether they're going to be offered on the website or emailed out. So Nick, if you just hang on a second, we'll get you squared away.
Yeah, we'll have all that we'll send out with the resource list on where you can get the slides and the recordings.
Thank you. PsychArmor. I mentioned PsychArmor in session one, and it's a wonderful nonprofit that offers free education opportunities to civilians, and their focus is really to help bridge the military-civilian gap. So check out their trainings. They're very well done. There's that video that I referenced in session one on 15 things veterans want you to know. Great video if you haven't checked it out already, but there's a ton of resources there to help build your veteran cultural competency, among other things. Psych Hub is also a wonderful resource for mental health topics, and it contains tons of free videos on mental health, substance abuse, and suicide prevention. So that's an excellent one. Again, make a plug for my organization, the Military Families Learning Network. We do free professional development for military family service providers and cooperative extension educators. We're trying to, our wow is to increase those connections and handshakes among folks working on installations and in branch services with cooperative extension educators, so that we can get all these people working together and sharing resources and essentially, you know, providing a boat to navigate the sea of goodwill. So please check us out. We offer a lot of free continuing education credits as well, if you're interested, for social workers and finance managers. We have case managers, dietitians, patient advocates, all sorts of things. So check us out. We'd be happy to have you become a regular in our work, in our programming. Let's see. We have scholarships and jobs with USDA. So, and many of these are veteran specific. Navigating these websites might take a little bit of getting familiar with them, but you can select veteran-specific scholarships and jobs. So that's a great resource there. And then We also have a little YouTube video here for the VA telehealth program, Project Atlas, which is in some pilot stages, but it's a really great video. I hope speaks to things yet to come that are going to be familiar and accessible and a new normal for everyone. There's also a VA welcome toolkit that could be of use. That's a PDF that you can download. And you can also check veterans eligibility for healthcare at the link there at the bottom. So lots of stuff here, and I just wanted to give a general overview, but again, these will be slides will be mailed out to you. We have the Word document for you to download. I will be adding in everything that you all have shared in the chats since day one, which are excellent resources, and I really want to recognize you all as experts as you're doing this work. We're learning from you, and I know we're learning from one another, but you're on the ground doing this work, and we really appreciate the work you're doing and really value all the input and resources that you have shared with us the past couple of weeks. So I invite you to continue to share. I'm sorry, I lost my place in the chat. If there's anything that I need to revisit and draw some attention to, we'll do that. But keep sharing if you have anything more to offer there. And I think, Crystal, are we turning it back to you right now?
Yes, we are. So we are, we're going to go through a recap. So we've come to the end of the content pieces that we're going to share. And we just want to do a quick review of what we've done. And then we're going to ask you at the end of that review to engage in an activity with us that will help share, one thing that you're going to take away. So just by way of review, we started this session, this three-part series talking about veteran cultural competence. And Bridget talked us through some of those pieces. She reminded us of the Psych Armor resource and site there that provided a lot of those resources. We talked about cultural competence. We also talked about data. And Sarah shared a lot of resources for data and also gave some assignments around helping to find and explore those new data sources. So how might we find the data that could be useful for your own communities? We talked about assets, and we used the Community Capitals framework to look at the assets or the resources available in your own communities to support your efforts with veterans. And we built on that to think about partnerships, the partnerships that we already have in place, the new partnerships that could be formed, or the new ways that we could be working with the partners that we already have, thinking about all of that as the resources available to help us in our projects. We moved from there to talk about goals and how do we build SMART goals that will really help us to accomplish our task and make sure we'll be able to know when we've been successful. Then we started today talking about bridging, which really is an opportunity to pull all of those components together and say, okay, here is our goal. Here's our big vision, our wow, what we really want to see happen, right? This is our aspiration. This is why we do this work. Here's the big wow. And then to take a step back and say, here's present reality. And you use the data pieces there. You use the assets, the resources there, the partnerships that are in place there. And say, here's what it looks like now. And then in the middle, you flesh out the how do you get there? What are the action steps? And that's where you can, pull on the pieces from your SMART goals. You can pull on the potential partnership opportunities for whether expanding current ways that you're working with partners or reaching out to new partners, finding new data, making those connections, all of the things that you all talked about today, and then what you can individually be doing in those spaces as your how. And then, we wrapped up with the resources. So the resources that are in place to help accomplish all of those pieces. How do you get to the wow? What is it that you do? And so much data, so many resources that are available that you have. And so as you share those out, it's just going to build on what everyone has access to and the knowledge base. So again, that sea of goodwill that was talked about, we're starting to close some of those gaps as you get a chance to network and share out the resources as well. So those are the pieces that we've covered in the three sessions, a quick highlight. And now we're gonna ask you to engage us in this activity and identify a takeaway for you. And as you identify a takeaway for you, we're gonna ask you to take a minute to find something near you, an item or an object near you that could be a visual representation of something that you're gonna take away. And we'll ask you to leave that in sight, whether it's on your desk or somewhere nearby, so that that's a visual reminder to you of what you're gonna take away from the session. So I'll share my example is welcome. It may be showing up backwards. I'm not sure how the mirroring does. But I've moved this welcome sign for this activity today because I want to be welcome to new ideas, new resources, and new ways of doing things. So that's what I'm taking away. So if you'll take a moment to grab something nearby you, and we'll come back and share out. If you can share on your camera, that's fantastic. If not, you can tell us what it is and then share that out. So if everyone will take a moment and grab something nearby, we'll come back and start sharing. All right, so let's hear from some others and we'll just, politely chime in when the space is made available. And those who are willing to share your takeaway, we'd love to hear from you.
I'll go ahead and share. I have this little mini feeder to remind me to keep combining work with others and resources and strategies and efforts so that we can have new and different outcomes in our work. So, little mini guy.
I'll share.
Oh, go ahead, Carol.
Okay. I have my camera, which I always keep next to me. And the camera is a reminder of to capture so you see what you have, but then also when you look at the pictures, what are you missing? And I'm going back to the community capitals lesson and saying, what do I have and where do I still need to reach out? And so it's capturing all that information.
Thanks, Carol.
So I have a little, it's a macrame pot holder, but it's a good reminder to me of the importance of continuing to build networks so that they can support our veterans and all the folks we're working with.
This article was featured in Iowa Farmer Today, but also went to Missouri and Illinois. And it's about veterans working with agriculture to improve water quality with food production.
Thanks, Ray.
Hello, I am Luisa, and I'm going to share my Spanish book, which is, and this reminds me, I'm teaching about 7 or 8 women, veteran women, Spanish. So this is telling me that although this is all going on, veterans wants to continue learning. So we're doing this online twice a week. So this is the book.
Thank you, Luisa. Thank you.
I would like to say I'm looking forward to your resource list because that's where I struggle is trying to figure out who is doing what or where do you, when you go do a sales pitch, you have to find out their needs or mission statement before you do a sales pitch. I'm going to ask for help. I'm not sure what they really do sometimes. And you just chase your tail.
Yeah. Well, it's coming. It's going to come soon, I think. Kayla has shared in the chat, imagine me holding a shoe to represent me needing to put my feet to the ground and get out to meet people. Okay, thanks, Kayla. So again, we'll come back and just make the suggestion that you keep whatever that item is, somewhere that's visible to you as a visual reminder of, on those days that get to be tough. And we're hearing more and more of those tough days as the coronavirus issues, trudge on. But having that as a visual reminder of, you know, what's spurring you on, what's a takeaway, and what you want to do, we hope that that's a helpful and useful tool for you. So I am going to wrap up this piece. It has been such a joy to be with this group. We have done our touch base meetings in between, and we've just been so pleased. We thought we would be able to be face-to-face, and we're virtual, but we've been so especially appreciative for all of you with your sharing and leaning in to the session, and we've learned and grown a lot too. So having said that, I'll just say thank you, and I want to turn it over to Bridget to close us out.
Thank you, Crystal, and I want to second everything you just said. It's been a pleasure working with and getting to know you all and hearing about the work you're doing, all of your successes, your challenges, and I know for me, it's really helpful to know, you know, we're not alone. We're doing this work together. So stay in touch. Let's keep in touch. Let's keep sharing. And we will all be doing better work for it. So thank you. We have a couple of minutes, and I wanted to just open it up to the group in case anyone has any final things they want to share or mention or talk about. But before I do that, I did want to remind you once again that resource document is going to be coming to you via email. So do watch your email. Along with that resource document, there's going to be a link to an evaluation of the workshop, and we would really love to get your feedback and learn what we can be doing better as we continue to provide these workshops. We're hoping to provide a few more, so we really will value any thoughtful feedback you have. So check that evaluation link out as well. You also will get the slides you know, the videos are still there for you to review. I believe you'll be getting also recordings of the sessions in case you missed a session or two. So this will all be here for you, and we really appreciate you. So thank you. So a couple of minutes, if anybody wants to open up their mic and share or ask any questions or.
And we share this information with some of our partners that we work with, so they're on the same page and help us all build a bigger collaborative resource. Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Please share. And let's see, I guess session 1 and 2 recordings are already up on the website. So that's awesome. Thank you.
Bridget, this is Ted Alter. Thank you so much for everybody who participated in these sessions and for all of you who put this together. It goes to what I wanted to share, but I couldn't find my book, Crystal. But I hopefully, let me see if I can get it up. I don't know if you can see that or not.
Yes.
The Medici effect?
Yeah, okay, there we go. Yep.
So the Medici effect is about at the intersection of difference, that's where the likelihood of creativity and innovation occurs. Uh-huh. And that's what this session's been about, all 3 sessions. And it's in my experience, it's the same thing working with veterans and other groups in the community settings, always looking absolutely. For difference and learning from it.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much. We appreciate that, Ted. We will add that to the resource list. And you're right, creativity and innovation are just, they're foundational to doing this work in new and different ways and leveraging partnerships in new and different ways. So absolutely, thank you.
We're talking to ourselves, we're singing the same song. We got to exactly. talk to different people.
Exactly. Thank you.
I guess just to go along with Ted, since we're on the crossroads thing, I've had this on my desk since I've started. I'll just read it to you real quick. I don't know where it came from, but the first thing is always think like a traveler. Do your field observations with fresh eyes. Treat life like an experiment. Have an attitude of wisdom. Use your whole brain and do what you love. And I guess to represent that, my office is kind of weird. We buy each other weird stuff all the time. Bill bought me, I don't know if you could see it.
Oh, I see it now. Yeah, anyway, it's a little hard with your background, but yeah.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, it's George Washington on the Potomac River with his buddies. So it's just that idea of traveling and moving and exploring and just doing doing what you love to do. So.
Oh, that's awesome. Thank you so much, Mike. Appreciate that. Appreciate all your contributions. And David sharing in the chat, everyone needs to remember that no one is alone in this business of taking care of veterans and their families. There's always someone out there to help you help them. That's so true. Thank you, David. That's a wonderful sentiment to be reminded of. Thank you. Well, excellent. Thank you again, everyone. It's been a real pleasure to get to know you all and to have these opportunities to talk with you and learn from you. Watch for an email with all of these resources that we have been co-creating over the past few weeks, evaluation link, and recordings are up on the website, so feel free to share. And I will also make sure that you have our emails, mine and Sarah's and Crystal's, should you have any questions. Please feel free to email us at any time. We will be happy to hear from you. And Rachel sharing in the chat that the evaluation link just went live. So she has a link to that evaluation right there in the chat. Again, we will send that link to you over email so that you can give us some feedback and we can continue to improve on this workshop. So once again, thank you and really appreciate you all.